Yeah, it was a little bit of a process. When he left, I was still debating if I was going to go there or not, being the coach. I forget his name. Yeah, I forgot his name. Me and the coach, I got to meet him. We went out to lunch. And again, there was like a little deadline to figure out what I wanted to do. And then he's a great guy. It's just one night. I wanted to film. I wanted to open back up my recruitment and see what was available. And then again, I talked to Coach Hugs again, and he reached out to me and told me I had a spot here. So I was very happy to have a spot.
I'm going to say, well, I mean, obviously you'd rather play in the Big 12 than in the conference.
Conference USA?
So it's a bigger, more
prestigious conference, a lot more attention, a lot more things going on, a lot more exposure for me as a player.
You said it was a journey. Did it feel like one? I mean, just kind of listening to you.
I mean, it was a journey. Now I feel like time went by forward a lot more faster than I thought it would. You know, the process, going through the grind, and going from one JUCO to another JUCO, trying to get to where I'm at now. It's kind of a humbling experience now that I'm actually here. It was a journey. Yeah, always going around. It's hard to stay though, I'm out here.
It's hard to find a place to call home in a situation like that. It seems like once you get to know some place, you're moving on to the...
Yeah, there's a few mistakes I made in my past, you know, when I was younger. Kind of grow up and mature a little bit. So it wasn't really... It was kind of my fault in a way. You know what I'm saying? I kind of put myself in a situation in a hole and I dug myself out and kept grinding.
Is that why you weren't coming out of high school?
Yes,
or weren't Division I?
Yeah, that's
right. How much of a plug? I mean, seeing guys that you knew you were as good a player as going
to... It hurt me. Most of my friends, people I came close with, you know, just playing outside at home. A lot of guys moving on to higher levels, and I still had to go JUCO, which was like a mindset, right? You know what I'm saying? That's why I said it was a journey. Because I wanted JUCO all by myself. It wasn't like I had friends that went with me. Most of my friends went on the higher level, and I just had to work my way up.
When you say a setback, obviously you were aware of it. Did that, like, drive you? I mean, is that...
I say it did drive me because I wasn't aware I had to go JUCO. I thought I wasn't qualified. So when I realized that I had to go JUCO, it kind of put me in my place, kind of. So, yeah, I say that was...
You come into this situation now, and he's kind of trying to change things where schools were pressing, playing more players, playing more up-tempo. Is that fit your style?
It's my style. It's not really just playing hard. You know, playing for hugs, you just got to play hard in possession. And I'm still getting used to it. I'm getting there, playing hard in possession, getting everything I got. You know, when I'm tired, call myself out, get a sub, and I'm ready to get back in. More for like my teammates, so we can stay in it. Ain't no reason for me to be on the floor tired, not giving all I got. You know what I'm saying?
The full court pressure in practice looks good all the time. Looks good half the time.
You know, we had some good practices. We had some okay practices. I mean, lately we've been having some really good practices, high intensity, getting after each other, getting everybody getting each other better. You know what I'm saying? Working on some things that we had to fix: defense, offense, and shots. Just small things that we need to fix.
Kind of acquainted with the treadmill, is it?
Oh yeah. Yeah, you make a mistake, it's treadmill time.
Anything that
it's a bonus though. You see, at times like this, when teams are on the gas, we still got the extra push. So them treadmills come handy. Not at the moment.
Any significance to numbers you're